Hello students, welcome you all to the next part regarding discussion of the steam turbines, a continuing session. In the last session, we have discussed regarding the introduction to steam turbines theory part, then a small derivation for the condition for maximum blade efficiency of a single stage impulse turbine. In today's session, we'll be solving some of the problems on the steam turbines using the graphical method. Okay, so let us begin with the problems. So this is the first question which you can see on the screen. It is being said that there is a single stage impulse turbine which has a diameter of 1.5 meter running at 3000 rpm. The nozzle angle is 20 degree, the speed ratio of 0.45, ratio of relative index at outlet to that at inlet is 0.9, outlet blade angle is 3 degrees less than inlet angle with steam flow rate of 6 kgs per second. Draw the velocity diagrams and find the following. Number one, velocity of furl. Number second, axial thrust. Number third, blade angles. Number four, power developed. And the number fifth one is blade efficiency. So before we move to the solution of this entire problem, let us note down the given data which is present in this particular problem. So if we start from the initial step itself, he has said that there is a single stage impulse turbine. Then he has said it has a diameter of 1.5 meter, that is D. D is equal to 1.5 meter. Then D is 1.5 meter. Then it is said that it is running at 3000 rpm, that is N is equal to 3000 rpm. The nozzle angle is 20 degrees, that is alpha 1, it is equal to 20 degrees. Speed ratio is given as pi is equal to u by v1, which is equal to 0.45. So this is the speed ratio. Ratio of relative index at outlet to that at inlet, that is vr2 by vr1 is equal to 0.9. Outlet blade angle he has told, which is nothing but beta 2, and he says this blade angle, outlet blade angle beta 2, it is 3 degree less than the inlet blade angle. So beta 2 is nothing but less than inlet blade angle, that is beta 1 minus 3. He has said the steam for it is 6 kgs per second, that is m dot 6 kg per second. Then he has asked us to find out the velocity of furl, that is delta VU, which is equal to V1 plus V2, axial thrust FA, we should not calculate, blade angles beta 1, beta 2, power developed, as well as blade efficiency. These are the terms which he has asked us to find out. Before we start a solution of this particular problem graphically, we need to assume a scale. So generally the scale which you are assuming, it depends upon the two important velocity factors. One is your tangential speed. So your tangential speed, generally you are writing in a form of a symbolic form known as U. Tangential speed, U. Or velocity, absolute velocity at inlet or outlet, you can refer it. With respect to this, you need to assume the scale factor, because these will be having maximum magnitude. So if you have velocity at inlet, depending upon that, you can choose the scale, whether it has to be in terms of 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 centimeters. Okay. So now here, if you observe in this given problem, we have said that the tangential speed, that is U, you can calculate using this diameter and the speed of this equation. So therefore, we note on the given data, the speed ratio, The relative velocity ratios, beta 2 minus beta 1 is equal to 3, beta 2 is equal to beta 1 minus 3. Then as I said, using my tangential speed equation, that is u is equal to pi dn by 60. I get the value of u from this particular equation. Then once we have u, we can substitute the value in this speed ratio equation. That is pi is equal to u by v1, where I will get the value of v1 from this particular speed ratio equation. Now, for choosing the scale, you can remember that always if the value of the absolute velocity at the inlet or at the outlet, if it is more than 500 to 1000 meters per second, you can choose it as a scale of 1 centimeter, scale of 1 centimeter is equal to 50 meters per second. This is up to a velocity of around, you can say, lesser than 700 meters per second. You can choose this particular scale. If the velocities of factors are more than 700 meters per second, then you can choose 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meters per second. When it is greater than 700 meters per second. Why we need to choose a scale is because in your answer sheets, you need to fit these velocity triangles, and by drawing the velocity triangles, you need to determine the other velocity terms. That is the reason that you should fix them correctly. And another important point is when you are finding the values graphically, take care that the values which you are getting, you should be marking them exactly. If there is more fluctuation, then your answers will be varying from the given key answers also. So you have to take that into consideration and start plotting the velocity triangles graphically using the scale. Now in this particular problem, I will take the help of the scale as 1 centimeter is equal to 50 meters per second as my scale. The beginning of the solution. Once I find out the value of u using my tangential speed equation, that is u is equal to pi dn by 60, with the help of this scale of 1 centimeter is equal to 50 meters per second, I will draw a horizontal line, that is our tangential speed value of u. Then from the left end of this tangential speed, here I mark a point and alpha 1 is 20 degrees. I place a protractor here with 20 degrees. I point it and extend this line. This is alpha 1. Using the speed ratio equation, once we have found out the value of u, I can substitute here and I will get the value of the velocity, absolute velocity, that is v1. So then thereafter, I mark the value of v1 on this line. Somewhere here it cuts. This is my absolute velocity, that is v1. From here, I join back to the other side of this u. This is the relative velocity at inlet, that is vr1. Then what you can do is you can extend the other side of the u in the form of an dotted lines. You can draw some dotted lines, extend it. Similarly, the vertical lines, draw them, extend it. So this vertical dotted line, it is representing the velocity flow at inlet, that is vf1. Measure the value of vf1 using your scale. Convert that into meters per second. Similarly, you can measure the value of vr1, convert into meters per second. Then place your protractor at this point and find the value of beta 1. How much is the value of your beta 1? Then, already we have said this is the value of u. Your absolute tangential component of the absolute velocity inlet, it starts from here and it is marked up till here. That is, this is known as vu1. Once you know the value of beta 1, already in the equation, in the given data, it is there. Beta 2 is the thing, what? Beta 1 minus 3 degree. So now what you need to do is For the outer velocity triangle, I will be using red color ink. I will place the protractor here, and whatever the beta 2 value I get, I mark it on this side. I draw the line. Then already we have measured the VR1 value. We are having an equation VR2 by VR1. We are having an equation which you can see here. Using this equation, I will find the value of VR2. Once I find the value of VR2, then on this particular line, I cut the value of VR2 somewhere here and join back. If you observe here, I will draw the vertical dotted lines. Similarly, the horizontal dotted lines. Now, this is VR2. It is making an angle of beta 2. Here, alpha 2. This is V2. This is VF2. You have to measure all these velocity terms. And from VF2 to U, it is nothing but it is VU2. You should measure all these terms and convert them into respective meters per second unit. Therefore, the distance horizontally between VF1 and VF2, between VF1 and VF2, that is from here up till here, it is nothing but the net overall velocity, that is delta VU. This is delta VU, that is VU is equal to VU1 plus VU2. Similarly, the vertical difference, vertical height difference, that is from VF1 to VF2, that is VF1 minus VF2, you will get it as delta VF. This is the procedure to draw the velocity triangles, find the values graphically, and find the other things. So now let us see. These are terms which we need to find out as he had asked. And already I have drawn the velocity triangle. So initial point, draw the tangential speed using the tangential speed equation U is equal to pi dn by 60, that is 235.65 meters per second. You can find the value of V1 using the speed ratio equation. The value of velocity at the inlet is 523.66 meters per second. Then I take the scale as I said, 1 is centimeter is equal to 50 meters per second. First, I draw the tangential speed, that is U, a horizontal line. Once again, I will show you this. I will draw the tangential speed as my horizontal line with the scale. Then from this point, I mark alpha angle 20 degrees with the velocity of V1 up till here. Once this point is located, from here, I come back towards this one. This is my VR1. I measure the angle. I have got already as 35 degrees as beta 1. Then complete other part, vertical component as VF1, and from here draw dotted lines, that is we get the value of from U completely to VF1 as VU1. Then beta 2 is less than 3 degrees less than beta 1, which means 35 minus 3 is 32 degrees. So here this becomes your beta 2. Place your protractor here, mark for 32 degrees and extend the line. Once you have measured the length of VR1, we have the equation VR2 by VR1 is equal to some constant is given already in the problem. So therefore, from that, you will get the value of VR2. You can cut it here and join back to get the value of V2 as well as VF2. So you should measure these values graphically and convert them into meters per second, which already I have done. Let us see here. So for the inlet velocity triangle, you can see I have got VR1 is equal to 360 meters per second, beta 1 35 degrees, VF1 180.5 meters per second, VU1 47.5 meters per second, beta 2 is 32 degrees. Then we have VR2 by VR1 is equal to 0.1, which is already given in the question. As VR1 is 360 meters per second, I will get the value of VR2 as 284.4 meters per second. Then from the outer velocity triangle, you can see that we have what V2 is equal to 157.5, VF to 155 meters per second, VU2 as 28 meters per second. Then the velocity of whirl, using the equation, you can measure the value directly itself. That is V1 plus V2, 15.5 meters per second. Axial thrust, that is the equation for axial thrust, we are writing it as M dot by GC into delta VF. So we write it as VF1 minus VF2 also. Substitute the values and the force which you get it as around 153 newtons. Similarly, the blade angles already we have measured. One is 35 degree beta 1, beta 2 is 32 degrees. Power developed, M dot E, our equation, or E is equal to U delta VU by GC. We can use that equation. Already U you have calculated, delta V you have measured. Substitute it and get the answer in terms of kilowatt. That is 720.28.786 kilowatts. Blade efficiency, the blade efficiency which you are going to get here using your blade efficiency equation, and the blade efficiency equation, it says that using 2u delta u by v1 square, it is 88.59%. This is our blade efficiency equation. One correction, students, here, this decimal point which you are observing right now here, it is not at this point, it should be at this point, okay? It should be at 72886. So therefore, when I shift it to kilowatts, it comes here, it is 728.886 kilowatts. This is the correct answer, okay? This is the correct answer. Make this correction, it should be 728886. 0.54 it should be. 545 it should be in watts. So therefore, after shifting it is 728.886 kilowatts. This is the first problem. Similarly, another problem is asked here. Steam is issuing from a nozzle to a D-level turbine at a velocity of 1000 meters per second. Nozzle angle is 20 degrees. The mean blade velocity is 400 meters per second. With blades symmetrical, he has said the blades are symmetrical. The mass flow rate is 1000 kg per hour. Friction factor is 0.8. Nozzle efficiency is 0.95. You need to calculate blade angles, beta 1, beta 2, axial thrust, power developed, blade efficiency, as well as stage efficiency. Now, if you observe, this is also a case of the previous problem itself. Only the thing here is, he has given us directly the value of mean blade velocity. So if you start from the problem, the steam is entering the turbine with a velocity of 1000 meters per second. That is V1 is equal to 1000 meters per second. Nozzle angle alpha 1 is 20 degrees. Mean blade velocity, already he has given, that is U, it is 400 meters per second. Blades are symmetrical, he says. When the blades are symmetrical, which means beta 1 is equal to beta 2. Mass flow rate, M dot, it is 1000 kg per hour, or you can write this in kg per second also. Kg per hour or in kg per second. You should write this in kg per second, because the power is written in watts. So therefore, you should convert this into kgs per second. Friction factor, it is nothing but Cb, which is equal to Vr2 by Vr1. Friction factor, it is 0.8. That is Cb is equal to Vr2 by Vr1. Its value is 0.8. Then we have the nozzle efficiency. This nozzle efficiency is around 0.95. We need to calculate the blade angles, that is beta 1 we need to calculate. Similarly, we need to calculate beta 2. We need to calculate axial thrust, that is FA. Then power developed, P, blade efficiency, as well as the stage efficiency we need to calculate. So you can follow the same procedure which you have done for the previous problem. That is, first you can assume a scale. So as the velocity is 1000 meters per second, you can assume the scale here as 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meters per second. You can, sorry, yes, 100 meters per second. You can assume this one. Then you can get the problem fit easily in your answer sheets. So first he has given us the value of mean velocity, that is u. I will draw the value of tangential speed. This as u. Then from this end, alpha 1 is 20 degrees with v1 as 1000 meters per second. I will draw this line. This as alpha 1. I will cut 1000 meters per second by converting into respect to scale. And I mark this value as v1. Then from this point, I connect here. I get the value of vr1. Continue this rotated lines horizontally on the other side. Similarly, vertical rotated lines. This gives us vf1. Here, this is measure this particular angle. We get the value of beta1. Measure the length of vr1. We get the value of vr1. Similarly, measure the length of vf1. Then measure the length of vu1. Vu1 from the flow velocity component, vf1, you can measure the value of vu1. Once you get the value of beta1, vr1, beta1 already has told blades are symmetrical, which means beta1 is equal to beta2. So what I will do is, I will place my protractor here with the beta 2. I will mark the point and extend the line continuously. Already in the question for us, he has said that VR2 by VR1, that is a CB, which is blade coefficient, or the friction factor, which he has said, which is equal to 0.8. Already we have measured the value of VR1, through which you will get the value of VR2. So then what I will do is, I will cut this on this particular absolute velocity line. That is the value of VR2. I will cut it here. And then I will join to find the absolute velocity at the outlet, that is V2. This is VR2. This is angle beta2. Extend this line to the other side. Similarly, the vertical line. This I get alpha 2, this I get VF2. Measure all these values, that is VF2, V2, VR2, alpha 2, and write them in the respective conversions in the form of meters per second. So once you are done with this one, the last thing is to find the value of delta VU, that is from here to here, you will get the value of delta VU itself, or the addition of VU1 and VU2 will give you the value of delta VU. Similarly, the difference between VF1 and VF2 vertical components, you will get the value of delta VF. Okay, students. So, as I said, yes, the mass flow rate we have converted into kgs per second at 0.2777 kgs per second. We have these values. I have assumed the scale as 1 centimeter is equal to 100 meters per second. Therefore, this is the velocity triangle which I have got by solving the problem. And I have got the value of beta 1 is 33 degree, which is equal to beta 2 also. I have measured all these values, which you can see already I have written on this picture. This is the shape of the velocity triangle which you are going to get. So therefore, solution step, we need to find out the things which he has asked us in the problem. The first one is from the inlet graph, we have written all these values. VR1 650, beta 133 degree, VU1 935, VF1 650. Similarly, from the ordinary triangle, beta 2 is 33 degrees, V2 290, VR2 520 meters per second, VU2 500 meters per second, VF2 80 meters per second, delta VF, VF1 minus VF2 is equal to 70 meters per second. Then axial thrust, already you know the equation, Fa is equal to m dot by gc into the delta VF, that is VF1 minus VF2. You get it in terms of newtons, that is 19.4 newtons. Similarly, power developed, P is equal to m dot E. E is U to V, U into delta V by GC. Substitute the values and write in terms of kilowatt. That is 109.41 kilowatt. Then we have the blade efficiency, 2U delta V by V1 square. Substitute the values and write it in terms of percentage, 78.8%. Yes, the final term, that is the stage efficiency. Stage efficiency is nothing but it is the product of blade efficiency and nozzle efficiency. Already the nozzle efficiency is given in the problem. Substitute the values and write the stage efficiency in terms of percentage. So another problem of today's session. He has said that the steam flows through a nozzle with a velocity of 450 meters per second at a direction which is inclined at an angle of 16 degrees to the wheel tangent. Steam comes out of the moving blades with a velocity of 100 meters per second in the direction of 110 degree in the direction of blade motion. The blades are equiangular and the steam flow rate is 10 kgs per second. Find number 1 power developed, number 2 power loss due to friction, number 3 axial thrust, number 4 blade efficiency, and number 5 is the blade coefficient. Whenever you find difficulty, you will try to draw a small sketch through which you can analyze what are the parameters given in the question to you. Now, if I analyze the parameters one by one, he says the steam flows through the nozzle with a velocity of 450 meters per second. For example, if I draw a small sketch here, just I am showing the view. Let us say that this is my rotor ring. Say here are my blades. These are my blades which are being mounted on this ring. These are the blades, the pink colored structures. And just now we have said that through the nozzle, suppose this is the nozzle through which the steam is released. So the angle which is formed here, we call this as alpha 1. So therefore, the velocity which is striking it is, it is striking with a velocity of 450 meters per second, that is V1. Then it is inclined at an angle of alpha 1 is equal to 16 degrees to the wheel tangent, to this wheel tangent which is having an inclination of 16 degrees. Then he says steam comes out of the moving blades. The meaning of the sentence is once the steam impinges these blades, it moves away through these blades and it comes again at this surface. So the angle what is formed here, this is the angle which is the when the steam is coming out from the blades. So this angle we term it as alpha 2. This angle we term it as the alpha 2. Alpha 2 is equal to 110 degrees and it is, he has said clearly that it is coming in the direction of blade motion with a velocity of how much? 100 meters per second, which means the value is V2. Here he has not given tangential speed, but instead of that he has given both the alpha angles as well as the both absolute velocities at the inlet as well as at the outlet. Another important thing in this problem, he has clearly mentioned that the blades are equiangular, which means beta 1 is equal to beta 2. Steam flow rate is given. You need to find out power developed, that is P. Power loss due to friction, that is PF, with respect to your relative velocities at the inlet and outlet. Axial thrust, FA. Blade efficiency, that is beta B. And blade coefficient as CB. These are the things which he has asked in the question. Now, here, as the speed is 450 meters per second and 100 meters per second, you can assume the scale as 1 centimeter is equal to 50 meters per second. So we don't have the U value, what we have with respect to V1 and alpha 1. So what I will do is, first I will mark a point here. Now from this point, I will be marking alpha 1, that is 16 degrees. I'll be extending this line. Then with my scale of 50 meters per second, for a value of 450 meters per second, from this point, I measure and cut here. I make an arc. Then from here, as I said, I'll be drawing the vertical line. Similarly, I will be drawing the horizontal line because still I don't know what is the value of u. So here, alpha 160 degrees with the velocity of v1. Then he has given with respect to the outer velocity triangle. From the same point, what you can do is place your protractor here. He has said 110 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction. You can go in the anti-clockwise direction. In the anti-clockwise direction for 110 degrees, draw a line. Mark a point and extend it. Then he has said for a particular speed of how much? 100 meters per second. So you need to convert this into 100 meters per second. That is in the form of your particular scale. And therefore, it cuts somewhere here. Okay. Then you can draw a vertical line, extend it. Similarly, draw a horizontal line, extend it. Okay. This is V2. You are measuring from the direction itself, that is from the anti-clockwise itself, that is alpha 2. No doubt you can measure from the other side, but he has said with respect to the relative velocity triangle, that is the reason that I have measured from the anti-clockwise direction as 110 degrees. Otherwise, if you come in the clockwise directions, it is around 70 degrees. Now, we need to find out the other terms. So what we can do here is, you can observe here, we can measure two lengths. This length we can measure here, that is VF1. Similarly, on the other side, we can measure the other length, that is VF2. Once you measure the length of VF2 here, extend the same magnitude of VF2 on the other side of the bottom line. We are below this line, extend the value of this VF2. See here, I have shown how I have extended. The same value, VF2. Then what I will do is, from this point, I will join the point of contact for VF1 here. Now, up till here, from here to here, this is your VR1 with angle beta 1. Measure the value of VR1, measure the value of beta 1. Then the distance, it is now exactly what? It is your tangential speed u. Measure this value of u. Already in the question, he has said that the blades are equiangular. So therefore, beta 1 is equal to beta 2. Then directly from this point, you can join here, we'll get the value of beta 2. Measure all the values, and then we can get the value of VU2, that is here. At the same point, we can get the value of VU1. Then we have delta VU, then we have delta VF, over, measure all these values and find the things which is asked in the question. So once all the values you have measured, then go on finding the things which he has asked in the question, that is power developed, power loss due to friction, axial thrust, blade efficiency, blade coefficient. So now, these things which we have discussed. Yes, this is the picture of the velocity triangle which I have got. So you can see here I have written the values. VR1 is equal to 85 meters per second. Beta meter 2 is equal to 26 degrees I have got. VF1 128.5 meters per second. VU1 432.5, U 181 meters per second, V2 105, beta to 26 degrees, VR to 236 meters per second, VF to 100 meters per second, VU to 40 meters per second, delta VU 472.5 meters per second, delta VF 28.5 meters per second. So now, sir, finding the things, power developed, we already have the equation P is equal to M dot E. E is equal to U into delta VU by GC. So substitute the values and get the answer in terms of kilowatt, that is 855.2 225 kilowatt. Here, the new term which he has asked in this problem is power loss due to friction. So generally, the loss due to friction, you have learned that it happens mainly because of the relative velocities. So if you observe in this picture here carefully, at these two points, at these two velocity factors, that is VR1 and VR2, these are the two velocity terms where there is the power loss due to friction, that is the relative velocities. So therefore, with respect to this, we need to find out the power loss due to friction now. That is F is equal to PF is equal to M dot by GC into delta HF. Delta HF is 1 by 2 VR1 square minus VR2 square. Now, on substitution and simplification, I get delta HF as 12,764.5 joules per kg. I substitute in the power equation and I get it as 127.645 kilowatt. Similarly, axial thrust, which you have learned already in the previous problems also, using the same equation, Fa is equal to M dot by GC, VF1 minus VF2, I substitute the values and I get the force as 285 newtons. Blade or rotor efficiency, we say that is eta B is equal to U delta U by V1 square. We substitute and we get the answer as 84.46%. Then we have the blade velocity coefficient, that is CB is equal to VR2 by VR1. We substitute the value and we get the value of CB as 0.828. These are some of the problems with respect to the impulse turbines which can be solved graphically. In the next section, we will be seeing some more type of problems and the other part, theory part for the module number 3, that is with respect to the steam turbines. Thank you, students.